It looks like Tesla has indeed acquired a new battery startup coming as a company, as Tesla confirms its acquisition of battery startup in a new patent. Welcome back, dear friends. This is Armin Haryan from TorqueNews.com. Fred Lambert from Electrek noticed this first and published a story in which he says Tesla confirmed that it quietly acquired Colorado-based battery startup SiILion Incorporation in a new patent for a silicon-based battery anode. Over the last few years, Tesla has been rumored to have acquired SiILion Incorporation, a battery technology startup based out of Colorado. The rumors started after a few of the startup's employees were hired by Tesla and the automaker started listing battery research jobs in Colorado area where it previously didn't have research and development operations, and many people were wondering why is Tesla hiring in Colorado since it doesn't have research and development there. The startup was working on a new high energy density battery chemistry based on high loaded silicon anodes. It described on its website that has since been shut down. Here is what a quote from Electrek, developer of an advanced lithium-ion battery designed to address the market's accelerated demand for higher performance energy storage devices. The company's technology delivers high energy batteries by simultaneously incorporating high loaded silicon anodes, nickel-rich NMC cathodes, and a non-flammable ionic liquid electrolyte, and offer an increase in both energy density and specific energy in lithium-ion batteries, enabling users to get safer and lower cost energy storage devices for defense, consumer electronics, and electric vehicle applications. I'm wondering if Tesla may have used some of this knowledge in its 4680 battery development. What do you think, friends? So Electrek says the startup received several grants from the US Department of Defense and US Department of Energy before going dark in 2018, while three researchers at the company changed their job positions to Tesla, co-founders Tyler Evans and Daniela Molina Piper never did. But we now can confirm, says Electrek, that their technology is owned by Tesla. One of the SiILion duo's most important patents, called large format battery anodes comprising silicon particles, is now listed as Tesla's. I will have the link of Electrek's story and the picture of the patent there. Tesla is listed as the applicant for the patent, while Evans and Molina Piper are listed as inventors. They describe the anode technology in the patent's abstract. Here is what the abstract says. Large-scale anodes containing high weight percentages of silicon situated for use in lithium-ion energy storage devices and batteries, and methods of manufacturing the same are described. The anode material describes herein can include a film cast on a current collector substrate with the film including a plurality of active material particles and a conductive polymer membrane coated over the active material particles. Well, this kind of sounds a little complicated, right? It's very technical, very term. So the method of manufacturing the anode materials can include preparation of a slurry including the active material particles. So this is going to be even more complicated, and I don't want to read you the whole thing, but you can see that in the link of the Electrek story, which I will have in the description of this video. Now, interestingly, during Tesla's battery day, the automaker confirmed that its new 4680 battery cell is powered by a new anode enabled by a new silicon. Earlier this week, Electrek and I also here reported of Tesla delivering a new anode production line at Gigafactory Texas. You can see that in my reports on YouTube. It wouldn't be the only battery startup that Tesla acquired to secure technology for its next generation 4680 battery cells, thinks Electrek. As they previously reported, Tesla also acquired Canada's Spring Power International International for its cathode technology. Well, friends, let me know your thoughts. This is Armin Haryan from TorqueNews.com. Let's continue the discussion in the comments section below. What do you think about this acquisition, what it will do for Tesla, and when do you think the Tesla's 4680 batteries are coming with cars running these batteries? God bless you, everyone. Peace be with all of you and with your families. And let's move on to the next story. Tesla's 4680 new battery program now is inching forward with Canada-based battery equipment new facility. Welcome back, friends. This is Armin Haryan from TorqueNews.com. Please subscribe to our channel for daily Tesla news. Tesla seems to be preparing to make the machines that will be used to manufacture its 4680 battery cells on a wider scale, says Maria Merano in TeslaRadi.com. She says the company plans to establish a manufacturing facility in the city of Markham in Canada that will build battery production equipment for its gigafactories worldwide. This is the first time that we're seeing a program from Canada related to 4680 batteries of Tesla. The mayor of Markham, Frank Scarpitti, announced Tesla's new manufacturing facility in the city of his mayor's review publication. Here's what the mayor said. He said, "I am delighted to share that Tesla Canada is joining our already robust automotive and technology ecosystem by locating a manufacturing facility in the city of Markham," the mayor wrote. "The facility will be the first branded Tesla Canada manufacturing facility in Canada, will produce state-of-the-art manufacturing equipment to be used at gigafactories located around the world in the production of batteries." That's what it said. Mayor Scarpitti's announcements noted that Tesla's major factories will receive battery production equipment, including potentially sites like Giga Shanghai. Tesla Canada facility in Markham will most likely produce equipment for the company's long-awaited 4680 battery cells. So far, Tesla has a 4680 production pilot line for its batteries on Cato Road near Fremont that seems to be making significant progress, as I've reported before. Friends, Tesla also plans to build a 4680 battery production line in Giga Texas and Giga Berlin, and a few days ago we saw the equipment for the building of Tesla's 4680 batteries coming to Giga Factory Texas. These are great updates about the production status of 4680 batteries of Tesla. Some battery equipment, like I said, was recently delivered to Giga Texas as per recent drone footage of the Giga Factory. The delivery hinted that Tesla is getting closer to producing 4680 battery cells outside its pilot line in California. Hopefully soon we will also have another update about Tesla's 4680 battery production in Gigafactory Berlin. According to Drew Baglino, Tesla's senior vice president of powertrain and energy engineering, tests of 4680 battery cells have gone well to date. Tesla expects the first vehicles with 4680 battery cells to be delivered next year. Now, tell me something, friends, if you hear, what do you think? Do you think you will wait if you're about to buy a Tesla? Will you buy Tesla now if you had a good deal, or will you wait until Tesla brings new batteries in production, the 4680 batteries, which are supposed to be with longer range and denser energy, or does this matter at all? So here's what Baglino said. Early next year, from a non-cell perspective, structural, battery, crush, range, and reliability testing are on track to be complete this quarter. Testing is to date has gone well, and the Fremont factory manufacturing line is on track to support. Baglino replied to a shareholder who asked about the expected delivery date for vehicles with Tesla's 4680 battery cells. That was the update. However, he reminded everyone listening in on the quarter 3 2021 earnings call that Tesla's timeline may change due to unexpected challenges. For instance, Tesla is still dealing with global supply chain challenges. However, this is a new architecture and unknowns may exist still, Baglino added. Our top priority is ensuring quality in what we deliver, and from a cell perspective, perspective, we are comfortable with the design maturity and manufacturing readiness matching the pack timeline I just mentioned, Baglino said. Friends, the first Tesla cars with 4680 battery cells will be the Model Y, followed likely by the Cybertruck or the Tesla Semi, writes Maria Merano in TeslaRadi.com. She says both Giga Texas and Giga Berlin will start operations making Model Y vehicles with Tesla structured battery pack and 4680 battery cells. Well, friends, let me know what you think about all these developments and Canada building parts for Tesla's 4680 battery manufacturing. This is going to be very interesting. I'm looking under Tesla Radi's article. One person named Bart has an interesting comment explaining the situation, saying Tesla acquired high bar systems of Richmond Hill, Ontario in 2019. Markham is located east of and right next to Richmond Hill. So I assume this is an expansion of Hebar or Hybar, Tesla's Toronto automation, Tesla Canada. Do you think so, friends? Let me know your thoughts. This is Armin Harayan from TorqueNews.com. Please subscribe to our channel. Also visit us on Twitter at TorqueNewsAuto handle and ring the bell that when you subscribe here after, so you don't miss my next coverage. I have another story coming later today related to 4680 batteries. Check on our YouTube channel. God bless you, everyone. Peace be with all of you. And let's move on to our next Tesla coverage.